It's about to go down. Period number three. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro, ready to bring you the action. Barring extra time, the final frame of this one. Here we go. Third period is underway. Chicago's got a hold of it against the wall. And now it's over to Hull. And a great heads-up defensive play here. Forces the turnover. Minnesota's got a hold of it along the wall. And he denied that opportunity. Picked off. Trying to be too cute on the pass.
Minnesota's done a really nice job positionally tonight. They've stolen the puck every time, it seems, when they needed to. Oh, look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here.
Passes it over to Bellows. Tries to get the puck to Kanye. Can't maintain possession after that hit. Officials blowing the play dead. We've got a penalty on the way here. The Blackhawks are going to be short-handed as they are called for tripping.
I always found this a frustrating penalty to take. There's really no aggression to it. You're trying to steal the puck, but you end up clipping the guy down.
Minnesota sending their power play unit out for the first time tonight.
They just can't take a penalty like this. Penalty. This is the number best 81. Power play in the league. You must have the man advantage. You're so dangerous. They've got the lead, and they'd like to increase it.
Quick feed to Hull. The Blackhawks work it through center. Moves it quickly over to Smith. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Rolston. Solid hit on that play. Chicago's got possession all underhand. Clearing attack. And clearing attack is a big success on that play. The Wild have gained possession off the wall. Here they come on the attack. Takes the puck as the clock ticks down on the penalty kill. Gets it out of his own end. One last rush here on this power play. From the right side, they gain the zone. Both said, outstanding save and a huge opportunity. Quick pass to Hossa. Receives the pass. And couldn't find the intended receiver on that one. Takes that pass back at the point. Denies him, he got all of it. Minnesota's gained possession along the boards. With some open space at center. Passes it to Mitchell. That pass doesn't go. Slides it across to Savard. Chaps the puck away. The Wild have possession along the boards. Tosses it to Mitchell.
He's got some room carrying the puck in the offensive zone. He's about to get his first goal.
Chicago's got the puck. And they send it right back to him. Here's the pass. Comes up with a stop. I think he got a blocker on that one.
Yeah, he's a sharp save, James. Right in the middle of the ice, he makes the stop and pushes it away.
Picked up along the boards by Hextall. And he takes a shot, and he comes up with it.
But he flares up the arm with the blocker. Makes a pretty good save here.
The Hurricanes are on the schedule next for these guys.
We had a coach, James, that would ask us in a random meeting, who are our next three opponents? You'd be amazed how many guys would get two of the three wrong.
What about you?
Always do.
You always do.
Yeah,
smartest guy in the room, right?
Oh, just paranoid.
They move the puck out of harm's way. Here's a short pass to Gagne. Nice dish from the left wing. Chicago's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Here he is with the backhander. Oh, the stick. Moves it to Suter. And now he tries to get it across to Burnett. Offside the call, and we'll have a face-off just outside the blue line. Past the halfway mark of this period, Minnesota's up 2-1, and the crowd has been enjoying this one. And they take possession. Nice job tangling him up on the draw. And now he moves it to Grant. Puts it on him, and he makes the save. Chicago's got the puck along the boards. Pokes it away in his own end. Picked up along the wall by Suter. Quick feed to Dumba.
It's a great save as he's able to snuff it out.
Chicago's got to be frustrated with how things have played out tonight, trailing in this third period. Swoops in off the wing to grab the puck after the centerman tied him up. Moves it quickly over. Scores! And look at the smile on his face when he's first.
Not just him, but he face. Everybody loves to see somebody get their first goal. Everybody seems pretty excited for him.
quick feed from Ralston. Takes the pass. From the left side, takes it to center. From the point, they take control of it. That opportunity is rejected. The Blackhawks will play it in their own end. The arms up, there's the whistle, and boy, look at the time here for a penalty coming up. The Wild have been penalized for slashing.
A little bit of frustration there. He's out of position, and he gets called for slashing.
The power play unit goes right back to work.
What an opportunity here with the power play in overtime. You take total
Wild
control
penalty,
of the
nine,
situation. One shot, one goal.
And the puck takes the zone. The Blackhawks have it behind the net. Quick feed to Savard. Floats it right onto the tape. Excellent stick work on the play. Puck is cleared out of the defensive zone. The Blackhawks have it against the wall. Takes the feed. Move to the middle. And he totally whiffs on that one. A chance to get it out. Big defensive play on that clear.
That puck's got to get out, especially late. He does a nice job here.
Couldn't complete the play. From the point, looks to make something happen. His reflexes on display tonight.
The most fun save for the goaltender. The glove stop.
Moves it quickly over to Kane, trying to get the puck out of his own end. Chicago's going to be hard-pressed to find better opportunities to win it than that as they come up empty-handed with the power play.
Sometimes the opportunity shows up at a really critical point. Here you are in overtime, you got a power play, and they don't cash in. Big miss.
Feeds it on over to Wilson. Here's an on-man rush. Easily turned aside by Roenick. The Wild have gained control of the puck along the wall. And he can't hang on after that hit. Can't keep a hold of it as he's jostled off the puck. Chicago's got it in their own zone. And he slides it quickly to Mikita. And sends it just out of reach. Slides the puck over. Nice pass. Here's a chance. And that one's turned away. Scooped up along the wall by Cirelli. He was locked in there. And now it's to Roenick. Moves it to the slot. Scores! Good night! Fair to say this one lived up to the hype tonight?
Last day or two, this has been all the talk about what an evenly matched game this is going to be. Well, it couldn't have been any better than this.
The Coyotes are on the schedule next for these guys.
We had a coach, James, that would ask us in a random meeting, who are our next three opponents? You'd be amazed how many guys would get two of the three wrong.
What about you?
Always do.
You always do.
Yeah.
Oh, smartest guy in the room, right?
No, just paranoid.
Martin's stick work will land him 2 minutes for slashing.
If you're going to slash, you better not make it so obvious. I mean, that's a penalty every time.
Man advantage unit is set.
It's been a really good game. Tied right now. But the top power play in the league gets to the penalty for the first time.
2 minutes. Taking a look at the
ball. 2 minutes. 32 seconds.
Slides the puck to Forsberg. Here he is in front. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. And the puck is cleared to a safer spot. And now it's over to Roenick. Moves the puck.
Hayduk's already got a power play goal as they're back on the power play again.
Made the save on the play.
Hasek's done it again. Another terrific save. And he's kept this game close.
Denies him! He got all of it! And the puck has moved to a safer spot on the ice. Colorado's got it in their own zone. Takes the pass from the left wing.
He's got some room carrying the puck in the offensive zone. He's about to get his first goal.
Quick feed to Rantanen. The Sabres get back to even strength after a huge effort by their penalty killers.
Sometimes a power play is more critical than others. Lots of pressure on that five-man group. They didn't get it done, though. They miss it a really important time.
And he makes the save. Hasek's got the puck. Boy, he's been under fire tonight.
Been really sharp, and in a close game, you can't make a mistake that costs a critical goal.
Getting into the later stages of this period, we are all tied up in this one. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Denies him with a save. Here's a short pass to Keane. Big save by the goaltender once again.
Really sharp. Never loses sight of the puck to make the second save. As soon as the player winds up, the goaltender moves out, squares up, and makes the save on the slot.
A critical draw here. LaFontaine's won it off the faceoff. Aaron pass and the play's broken up. Couldn't connect on that pass. Picks up the puck in his own end. Quick pass to Foote. And now it's grabbed by Sakic. Knocked away. Moves it over to Roenick. Inside the last minute here in this third. Forsberg's hauled down. Penalty on the way. Time for the official to pass down his sentence. Roberts is caught for the trip, and he's going on a trip to the penalty box.
Play was fiery, got burned, Ray.
He's digging around for the puck, and sometimes you just get caught. This time the player goes down, and he's got to go to the box.
Another chance here on the man advantage.
Buffalo penalty.
Colorado's won the trip.
2 minutes for tripping. Time of the penalty. 19 minutes, 7 seconds.
Gets it out of his own end. Passes the puck over to Rantanen. And tries to make a diagonal pass to MacKinnon. Hurry from denies him.
They came out and challenged him. Good save.
Denies him again.
After the first stop, he's in good position to make a second.
Puck knocked loose in neutral zone. Moves it to Rammer. Drills him! Colorado's got a hold of it against the wall. Moves it quickly over to MacKinnon. Here's a blast! Denies him on the play! Oh, that hurt from here. He scores! Is that a crappy if I'm on here? Is that number 100?
Yeah, that's cool. Congratulations. It's a cool number to get to.
Late in this third period. won the draw in the neutral zone. Couldn't connect, although not exactly an ideal pass to begin with. Continues.
They'll tell themselves they were close, and that's a good thing. But man, this gets heavy after a while, and you have to really work hard to pick up yourself to get ready for the next game.
And that'll do it for Ray Pearl. I'm James Cebulski. Thank you. And they are ready to drop the puck on period number three. Moment of truth for one team. Here we go. Third period is underway. Quick feed to Tarasenko. Heads deep inside the offensive zone. Oh, and he's shaking his head on that as they were so close.
They're in the lead, but that shot would have really stretched it out.
Looking to make something happen along the boards. The Flames gain possession along the wall. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Rissick stops it cold. Joseph's read the situation, and he's just going to let it breathe here, Ray.
Well, every once in a while, the goalie will get a sense that the guys are starting to run around. He's been on top of it tonight. Been an excellent game.
Still plenty of time left in this frame. The Blues are clinging to a 2-1 lead. Puck grab by Unger. Here's a short pass to Federico.
He's never scored, but watch him wind through the offensive zone. He looks like he's got plenty of confidence.
And that's stopped by the goaltender. Great save to stay with it.
Nice move by the goalie to get out close to the shooter.
At center ice now. He grabs the puck. Looks to make a play over to Reinhardt. Nice pass. Quick pass to Aguila. Oh, what a stop! The Blues get a hold of the puck along the boards. Moves it to Federico. Receives the pass. Passes right to the front. Turned aside with the glove. Nice puck check inside the attacking zone. That's a good footwork to kick it away. Calgary's got the puck along the boards. Down the right side and into the zone. Moves into the slot. And he comes up with it.
quick as you can. Maybe it'll hit you, but it's so close to the net that pass is on the tape and off the tape in a hurry.
Calgary's made this one a fun one for the stretch drive, all evened up in the third.
It's never easy chasing the game. They've found a way to get the equalizer. Now short to the game right now.
Scored by number 21. Assisted by number 32.
The ball is scooped up along the board.
Number 12.
Jerome Williams has it against the half wall.
6 minutes. Oh, how about it get there? So crowded in front of the goaltender.
Made the stop on the play. Calgary's got it against the boards. And it's a quick pass to McDonald.
Shooting area.
The Blackhawks are next up on the schedule.
Some guys will know that. Some guys just leave it until they get through the current game. I think it's better to know a little bit about what's coming down the road.
Moves it quickly over to Nieuwendyk. Coming down the left wing and into the zone. And he slides it quickly to Pinot. Fires it on net. Answers the call with a big save. There's another stop.
The goalie makes a couple of excellent saves.
James and Ray with you tonight. More than half the period has been played. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Taking four out. And that puck gets out of here in a hurry after it rings the bell.
Yeah, good shot. Good shot, but deflects off the iron out of play.
Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. St. Louis with a big defensive zone faceoff. And now he moves it quickly to Mellenby. Puck picked up by Perron. Puts it on net, and that one's turned away. Quick feed to Roussel. Takes the feed. Moved out in front. Scores! The go-ahead goal!
Now this game has been tight. Now somebody's got a leg up. He got clear in the low slot, found where the opening was, and takes that pass to one time and pass the goalie.
Calgary's gone up by one. What's the strategy now, Ray?
Nothing really changes except you're cognizant of the fact you have a one-goal cushion. But you want to play on the ice, you want to be a winner.
Number nine. Lane McDonald.
Oh, he'll feel that one.
By number 29.
By number 26.
Time of the goal. 12 minutes.
Tries to feed it over to Backus. Rocks him. Here he is. Wrestling on that. Stops him with the blocker. Puck moved over to Roussel. Set in deep and the forwards will go to the bench. Takes the feed. Now a quick pass to Mellenby. Too many bodies in the way. Knocked off the puck. The Blues have it against the wall. Pokes it away in his own end. Takes the puck along the boards. That pass goes a little sideways. And now he angles it across to Pronger. And too much traffic in front. Blocks that one. Puck scooped up by Giordano. Calgary's got it in their own zone. Here's a short pass to Nelson. The Blues gain control of the puck against the wall.
The Blues have tied things up late in this third.
Really tense finish coming up. Now you don't have much time. That's a late goal for the win.
Attacker out here with the empty net on the line with his faceoff.
A lot of pressure on the centerman. You need the faceoff.
The Blues win the draw. Feeds the puck to Berenson. Slides the pass over to Jackman. And it's a quick pass to O'Reilly. And he's tripped up on the play. Referee's hand goes up here. Can't get it to go. And a pass! It's in the net and they score!
Doesn't take the very long.
More than half the period left to play. The Sharks lead it 4-2. Bathgate's won it. Quick pass to Leach. Hammers a shot, stopped by the goaltender.
Jones must feel pretty comfortable playing with a nice lead, but he's been sharp. He's been all over the puck tonight.
Feeds it to Thornton. And a nice poke check inside the neutral zone. Off the left wing and into center. And he takes a shot, makes the save with the glove. Jones hangs on for the whistle and a much-needed one, I would say, Ray.
He's been busy since the first period, but he's been excellent. I like the way he's controlled the rebounds, the way that he's given his team a chance. It's been an outstanding night for him.
The Oilers are who the fans can look forward to seeing next year in town.
Yeah, they enjoy when these two teams get together. It's usually a pretty feisty affair.
It's also Ray Ferraro bobblehead night that night, so get those tickets while you can.
I know you're fooling around, but I'll tell you, I did have a bobblehead that night.
Really?
That's fantastic.
Moves it to Rattel. Takes the feed.
You saw the lane there, James. That's a good pass.
Oh, they keep that one out. What a save. And he regains control of the puck. Moves it quickly over to Graves. Gains the zone through center.
Make a change, make a change.
And the goalie leaves his crease to play the puck. Slides it across to Graves. Comes up with the stop. More than half the period has gone by. Hope you're enjoying this one. San Jose's been the better club as they hold a 4-2 lead at this point. And now it's grabbed by Leach. Inside the defensive zone, moving the puck. A shot! That goes off the mask!
What do you think hurts more? He's got a headache or his jaw sore? That thing was a bullet.
Steps into the offensive end. Quick feed to Nash. Couldn't make that one happen. San Jose's gained possession along the boards. Centering pass! Huge steal at his own end. Picked up along the wall by Pavelski. And the puck's buttered away. The pass over. And he slides it quickly to Vlasic. The Sharks will play it from the defensive zone. Big time hit. New York's got a hold of it along the wall. Quick pass across to Bathgate. Oh, and he tracks it perfectly in the offensive end. Great read by the keeper to poke it away. Puts it up front. Let's the wrister go. Tremendous stop by Lundqvist. And a penalty is coming. Pavelski's two-handed chop is going to send him off to the box.
He was about halfway through that swing, James, and the official had his arm in the air.
Would have been at least a base hit in your days as a ball player.
Well, that might have been more than that.
Sharks.
The momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone.
Common penalty. 14 minutes, 27 seconds.
Let's go! Off the mask of the goaltender. Boy, right between the eyes.
That's gonna hurt. I don't care how much equipment you have or how good the mask is. That thing's coming 80 plus miles an hour. That's gonna hurt.
More than half the period has expired. The Sharks have some breathing room as they lead by a pair. It's 4-2. San Jose's got a hold of the puck. Trying to clear. And mission accomplished, Ray.
Yeah, late in the game, it's defensive blue line, puck out. Offensive blue line, puck in. Nothing turned over at those two spots.
Got a hold of it against the wall. Up the neutral zone now. And skilled use of the stick to poke the puck away. Here's a short pass to Rattel. Slides the puck over.
Looks pretty confident with the puck on his stick here in the offensive zone. You know he'd like to get his first NHL goal. play, the goalie's got no chance. When you're in that close and you get the chance to one-time it, you're likely going to score unless you hit the goalie.
The Rangers are back at center ice, probably breathing a little easier now, Ray.
They needed to get one, James. If you trail by two for too long, the clock just runs Rangers out on you.
Chances, and yet they trail late in this third period. Pavelski's won the draw here in the neutral zone.
Scored by number 12.
Couldn't find the intended target.
Number 19, Joel Thornton.
The Rangers have it behind the cage.
Time of the goal.
Nice side entry from the left. Inside of the final minute here in the third. Hammers the shot. They score!
Shoot the puck there, and that just blows by the goaltender. He didn't really have a chance.
The Rangers are back at center ice, probably breathing a little easier now, Ray.
They needed to get one, James. If you trail by two for too long, the clock just runs out on you. You run out of time.
Rangers
score.
By
number 55.
He puts up his little token argument here. He's going to circle around a bit and try and regroup here as he goes to the penalty
box. Were you a haggler?
Always. You never think it's the right call.
The Sharks send out their man advantage unit at a most critical time of the game.
New York penalty to number 15. 2 minutes of interference.
The Sharks ready to go on the attack.
19 minutes, 36 seconds.
Slides the puck over to Duguay. Shoots it down. Tonight, but they skate away with the victory, Razor.
They were second best in a lot of races tonight. Yeah. The one thing they did have was they had quality shots, and they were able to finish just enough to get themselves 2 points.
On behalf of Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski. Thanks for joining us. Good night.
Thank you.